Hello, and welcome to the 50th anniversary virtual legacy gala to support the Pelham Arts Center. Thank you for joining us, and we hope you have fun tonight, because that is the main thing. I'm your host, Stephen Byfield, and I'm thrilled to be here tonight. We have a lot of heartfelt messages, surprises, and cool performers for you tonight. I hope you stay with us and bid on the auction items, and remember to support the Pelham Arts Center. So, here's how you bid. The auction is here at visions2020.giftsmart.com. Before you can bid, sign in or make your GiftSmart account, then click View Items to enter the auction. When you see a piece of art that inspires you or an item that you've gotta have, use your credit card to place your bid. You can place a single bid for any amount or set your maximum to automatically outbid the next guy. The auction doesn't end until November the 10th at 9 p.m., so keep a lookout and remember, we are all winners here because we are supporting the arts.
Welcome to the Pelham Arts Center 50th Anniversary Legacy Gala. I am so thrilled that you've tuned in tonight. Today we have performances, we have some phenomenal things that we're going to be celebrating tonight, the history of art, education. We have incredible people we're going to be thanking, who helped build what this place is today. I can't thank you enough for being here and for your support tonight. This is gonna be a great time.
Pelham Arts Center has such an incredible staff.
I've worked here for 10 years and this is a wonderful place to work.
I love seeing everybody's smiling face.
The Arts Center, the staff is like a family.
We actually call ourselves PacFam, or we'll use hashtag PacFam. Bridget is my family. Carolyn and Alex and Charlotte, they're my family. We're all family together.
So being away from them was very hard, and to see everyone back was amazing.
Our staff as a family extends so much farther beyond just the staff. We are a family of people who actually believes in community. People who joke around together, just people who are creative at heart, and they love this real idea of being a community.
Pelham Arts Center is about community engagement with the arts. We're here to inspire creativity. We're here to have you engage with art, to learn new things, exhibitions, supporting artists, performance art, free interactive art activities, art education, scholarship programs, outreach partnerships with 15 organizations in the last year. We're here to bring art to the people. We don't exist without our community. That's members like you. So thank you.
We can't wait to see all of you.
Good evening. I'm Lisa Koontz, chairperson of the board of the Pelham Arts Center. We're so grateful that you've joined us this evening, and we're so grateful to the many individuals who have made this event possible. Our honorary co-chairs, each one of them an integral force in propelling our organization forward. Andrea Archibald, Barbara Bretone, Sona Davidian, Nancy Davis, Nina Diefenbach, Missy Fink, Paisley Kelling, Terry Martell, Susan Nathanson, Peggy Nicholson, Clue Noble, Anna Reel, Diana Reishi, Carla Romita, Candace Taubner, and Nancy Warner. And our event committee, Nandini Anandu, Jennifer Bland, Annette Candido, Diane Essig, Paula McKeever, Jill Orlando, Anne-Marie Pitkin, and Katie Wilson. We're particularly grateful for our generous event sponsors and hope that you will join us in patronizing these locally owned businesses. Sotheby's McClellan International Realty, Meridian Risk Management, the Cincinnati Insurance Companies, Bischoff & Bischoff LLP, UBS, Stiefvater Real Estate, Westchester Collision, D. Ragno Landscaping, Symmetry Physical Therapy, Rockwell's, and Maria Italian Restaurant. And finally, we're so grateful for the longstanding and continuing support and partnership of our elected representatives, State Senator Alessandra Biaggi, State Assemblywoman Amy Paulin, County Legislator Terry Clements, and Village of Pelham Mayor, Chance Mullen. Creating a dedicated home for the arts at the center of our community was a visionary act. From that first vision, and through the hard work, determination, and loving care of many dedicated volunteers and staff, the Pelham Arts Center has served as a welcoming point of access to the arts for individuals of all ages, abilities, and levels of engagement for the past 50 years. Our exhibitions, programs, and classes have offered inspiration and creative outlet, creating empathy and connection, and building community both within and beyond its walls. This small but mighty organization has touched so many lives throughout its long and storied history. The Arts Center has continually adapted to the needs of local and neighboring communities and provided engagement and connection with the greater art world. With our momentous anniversary comes the opportunity to envision the future, how to meet the changing needs of our community and of our world, providing the opportunity for new generations to see, study, and experience art in a community setting. In 2020, our vision is a community setting with enhanced studio and exhibition spaces, sustainable and forward-looking improvements to our physical plant, and technology to efficiently support our administration and enhance engagement. We have an exciting opportunity to follow the footsteps of the visionary leaders who have stewarded the PAC through each phase of its rich history, and to ensure that we remain a vibrant, accessible sanctuary for the exchange of ideas and the expression of creativity for the next 50 years.
Hi, everyone. I'm Joe Salamini, Jr., owner of Meridian Risk Management in Pelham. Welcome to Visions 2020 and happy 50th anniversary to the Pelham Arts Center. I'm so glad that this gala is actually happening after being canceled due to COVID. And I'm even happier that the Arts Center gets to celebrate 50 years of bringing arts, programming, and scholarships to our community. Meridian and Cincinnati Insurance Company are proud to be sponsoring tonight's event. And now it is more important than ever that we keep our local nonprofits functioning as the global pandemic continues. I spotted some great auction items that I can't wait to bid on, and I'm looking forward to the short film and musical performances. Let's all come together and do what we can do to keep the Pelham Arts Center busy and thriving for another 50 years. Enjoy tonight.
The Pelham Arts Center is a nonprofit educational and cultural institution located in Lower Westchester, New York, providing access to study, experience, and appreciate the arts. For 50 years, we've provided opportunities to learn and experience art while fostering our connection as a community. When we recall our history, we are inspired to envision our future. So, how did this small but mighty organization begin? In 1969, the Metropolitan Museum of Art was preparing for its 100th birthday. For centennial initiatives, the Met reached out into surrounding areas, and the Junior League of Pelham responded to the call, sending a group of women for Met docent training. Nancy Warner, Peggy Nicholson, Clue Noble, Midge Co-op, and Katrina Herring became qualified docents and began planning a townwide arts festival called the Art Happening.
Art needed to be emphasized more than it had been, and we thought it would help unify some of the community, and we think it did.
I agree with that. Our life became the Art Center and the Art Happening, and we gave it our all. And it took a phenomenal amount of time and energy, emotional, physical, devotion, to get that up and running and going and successful.
On April 25th and 26th, 1970, hundreds of people gathered in the Pelham Memorial High School Gymnasium to enjoy artwork, performances, and all-day art making.
The local artists came and they had a chance to hang up their things, and that was such a good platform. It's so important for an artist to have that opportunity.
So I had my first show at Pelham High School, and it was connected with the Pelham Art Happening.
The first event of its kind in Pelham, the Art Happening sparked a demand for arts in the community like never before.
People were very excited to be able to participate, and they could just bring their art, and we hung it.
The Art Happening continued to grow each year, and the need became clear to sustain the happening as a more permanent presence in the town.
Wouldn't it be great if we had something in town like this all the time? Why can we only have something like this once a year? Shouldn't it be part of the fabric of the community?
Inspired to preserve the happening's creative and inclusive atmosphere, Barbara Bertone set out to establish a community art center on Fifth Avenue, and she assembled a steering committee of leaders that helped bring her vision to life. Their mission was clear: develop a new organization to be a year-round artistic hub. In 1975, the Pelham Art Happening Incorporated earned 501c3 status and began leasing two adjoining Fifth Avenue storefronts. Then came the immeasurable time, money, creativity, and elbow grease of the volunteers who transformed a former bike shop and real estate office into a gallery, an art studio, a gift shop, and a dance studio, known as the Pelham Art Center.
I mean, in this tiny little space, we sold prints, we sold real art, we had lectures, we had a gift shop.
Every time we had a new show, everybody that was volunteering, strictly volunteer, would come in and repaint the walls and, you know, put putty in all the holes. It was very much a grassroots, hands-on kind of place.
With local exhibitions and art classes, the storefront center was a treasured town asset, but the Pelham Art Center story was only just beginning. Next door was an abandoned corner property, formerly a city-serviced gas station, but to Mort and Carol David, it was a blank canvas on which Pelham Art Center would realize its mission. They approached City Services Vice President Sterling McKittrick about acquiring the corner lot, and in 1978, City Services leased the gas station for $1. 2 years later, the Fifth Avenue property was gifted outright to the Pelham Art Center.
The very thought of having an art center changed the mindset in the town. And I think it's been a real catalyst for community spirit.
It wasn't long before the Art Center board embarked on its most ambitious project yet: bring all Art Center activities under a single roof by constructing a brand new wing. John Rudolph, Stuart Epstein, and Diana Reishi chaired the campaign to turn the corner gas station into a work of art, a 5,700 square foot center that would be a welcoming point of access to arts. In 3 years' time, thanks to the support of hundreds of local families, companies, and organizations, a total of $430,000 was raised, enough to cover the cost of the new building. The new Pelham Art Center was completed in the fall of 1985. The arts now had a permanent home in Pelham, a beacon of creativity designed for the community and accomplished by the community.
You have to dream to be able to get somewhere. And I believe in planning and dreaming, and then things happen.
To provide any kind of art exposure, it is life enhancing for everyone, but particularly the children should be exposed.
A commitment to providing art education is what makes Pelham Art Center a cornerstone of creativity. Our outreach programs, camps, and classes for all ages have given countless students across generations a way to cultivate the ineffable awards of creativity and community. The Art Center has conducted outreach since 1976, with the first outreach programs supported by the Arts Council of Westchester, now known as Arts Westchester, a proud partner of Pelham Art Center to this day. In the decades since, our outreach has expanded to many classrooms and spaces and organizations that help bring art to those who need it.
Well, I think the aspect of having a formal place where art would be displayed, the appreciation of local art would be, and of course all the educational opportunities that would come from having an art center in town.
Community is invigorated by public access to art. The Pelham Art Center Gallery and Public Art Program hosts exhibitions of local, national, and international artists and curators. Hundreds of exhibitions have taken place at the Art Center, and with a public art program 25 years and counting, we are a thought-provoking force in Pelham and beyond.
And I think the placement of the Art Center always, for us, was the place where if you took a walk one day, you kind of ended up there or walked through there, mm-hmm. or if you were, you know, on your way to and from buying pizza, you'd stopped in and stopped, sure. you know, walked out or just walked around the courtyard for a minute.
The arts are key to experiencing new concepts and diverse cultures. Since the very start of Pelham Arts Center, public programs have celebrated art traditions from around the world. From our concerts and lectures to folk art programs and so much more, we're always imagining new ways to learn and engage with one another.
I love the involvement and I love seeing this place grow. I'm just so pleased to see all the different programs and the outreach into other communities and the professionalism, and this is fabulous.
And it also goes along with stimulating art for the community that you want your kids to be trained in art or have an art appreciation, and I think that's why you've had classes there to continue our mission.
It's an incredible asset to have this art center, and I'm just really, really hoping that it will just grow and fulfill the need of what it has done so far and keep growing.
The driving force for the majority of the people that worked on this project was creating a center in the community that could be shaped by the community, something that we all could enjoy together.
It's a treasure for this community, and I think over the years it's proven itself to be time and time again.
People from the surrounding communities come in, which they do already, but I want more to come in, and I hope that the Art Center expands. I just hope the Art Center gets bigger and better with every year.
The Pelham Art Center stands today thanks to those who carried forward the original spirit of the 1970 Pelham Art Happening. Our organization was built on a belief in the transformative power of art, a belief that lives today as we perform our mission with unstoppable creativity.
Wow, what an amazing story. Inspiring to see how Pelham Arts Center started and how far we've come. It's the reason why we're all here tonight. Let's keep the party going, and here's Barry with some information on the auction.
Hi everyone, I'm Barry Cherwin, and I'm here for three reasons tonight. To talk about some of the items at the auction, to ask you to bid on them, and then simply to ask you to donate to the Pelham Arts Center. Pelham Arts Center is one of the most important cultural institutions, not only in Pelham really, but in this entire region. And this year, we're celebrating our 50th anniversary. We offer services here that aren't being offered anywhere else, not only in Pelham, but in the entire region. And we want to continue to do that. And again, that's why I'm here. We have for auction tonight and for the next few days, some great items, including works by a number of very prominent artists that are connected in one way or another with the center. There's a fabulous mixed media by Alexander Ruch. He studied, he painted, and has been exhibited all over the world. He collaborated with Pablo Picasso, with Salvador Dali, and many others. He lived for many years in Pelham and was connected to and was very passionate about the Pelham Arts Center right up until his death in 1997. There's a work by Paul Michael Graves of Technobabble fame and Charles Fazzino, whose artworks are about as recognizable as any artist in the world. You see a work by him, you know instantly, that's a Fazzino. The piece that we have in the auction, Invading the Heart of New York City, you could look at and look at and look at from now until forever, and you still wouldn't discover everything that's in the piece. It's quite remarkable. There's a piece by Nikki Enright, whose work is somehow totally whimsical and totally thought-provoking at the same time. Very, very cool. Not easy to do that. There's Valerie Larco, a truly outstanding artist who's had solo exhibits at galleries and museums literally around the country and been in group shows around the world. And she lives, I think, about 10 minutes from here. You can bid on a terrific work by Eleanor Miller, who's been an instructor here for the past 30 years. And for all that time has not only been having impact as a teacher, but has been doing significant work of her own. Those are a few of the artists in the auction. You can bid on pieces by them or bid on other compelling works by other outstanding artists who have donated work to this auction. Catherine Defoe, Carol D'Inverno, Kate Favell, R.C. Hagens, Anki King, David Kramer, Barry Mason, William Scharf, and Edie Yanif. They're remarkable artists. Even if you're not planning to bid on the artwork, these artists are definitely worth looking at. Incidentally, all the contemporary artists have been offered a percentage of the sale price at tonight's auction for any works reaching a bid of $1,000. Besides the wealth of art, there are other incredible items we have as well. Let's start with something totally different, not only from anything else in the auction, but from anything else you've ever done in your life. It's a week on safari at Zulu Niyala in South Africa. You can go on two safaris a day, every day that you're there, or you can, let's say, spend a couple of days at the pool and go on eight safaris, whatever you want. The accommodations are 5-star, the food, first class. This again, 6 days, 6 nights for two on 45,000 acres in one of the richest conservation areas in Africa. Elephants, leopards, giraffes, monkeys, rhinos, etc., etc., etc. It's Africa. The sky is different there. Everything is different there. And you're benefiting the Pelham Arts Center, which gets a portion of each sale made. You have 2 years in which to use this great, great item. We have 3 hours of continuous music spun by DJ Stephen Byfield. His bio stretches like as long as my arm, but I'll just mention one thing. He was Prince's personal DJ in Toronto for years, that he'll give you every bit of attention, every bit of spontaneity and creativity that he gave to Prince for all those years. I'm being filmed tonight, filmed and edited, because I usually need a lot of post-production editing, unfortunately, by The Nerdy Duo. They're a new media art and design company located in Nyack, and they're donating their services for a half-day shoot and the editing that comes with it. So if you think I look okay, you might want to bid on that item. Pay attention here, it's one of the most exciting packages you'll ever see at any auction. This one's kind of for the alphas. First, let me tell you how it works. Pelham Arts Center is getting a portion of the opening bid and all bids past the opening bid. So opening bid, we're getting a percentage of, subsequent bids, 100% our way. Now, what you're bidding on. No matter what else in life you do, this will be something you will never, ever, ever forget. You'll drive a Lamborghini, a couple of Ferraris, a Bentley, a Continental, a GT, an Aston Martin, the most desired cars and the top models of those cars. You'll take a 90-minute lesson and it's drive, baby, drive. Some of the best driving roads in the New York area, interstates, winding roads, straightaways, even city streets, so you can kind of flaunt the car that you're driving. So it's like a half an hour, you're in the Porsche 911, bam, you're out of that and into the Ferrari F430 or the 360 Spider, bam, into the Bentley, bam, into the Lamborghini. It's crazy. It's more than crazy. It's insane. It starts and ends in Englewood, New Jersey. It's about 35 or 40 minutes from here. And there are about 50 dates to choose from, so scheduling will be easy. They will reopen in April of 2021. And if you want to bring a passenger with you, that's just fine, no extra cost. It's just a crazy thing. Here's another great item. And again, a portion of the opening bids are coming to the Pelham Art Center, and all subsequent bids past the opening bids are ours entirely. If you're thinking of hosting a party, but you don't want to deal with the shopping and the cooking and the serving and the cleanup, now's your chance to have it all done for you by a true culinary genius. It's Dinner for Eight by Victoria. Traditional or outside the box, it's your call. Victoria and Mark will cover all aspects of the meal, preparation, service, cleanup, everything. Victoria is Filipina. That's the cuisine she's most noted for, but she's equally adept at French and vegan and kosher and Thai and Greek and probably any category I'm leaving out. She's remarkable. You'll help design the actual menu, and that's where your involvement ends. Sit back, relax, converse, enjoy the meal, enjoy the company. And if you decide you want this catered for more than eight, you can do that. We will prorate that, so that's not a problem. There's a stunning black diamond and white necklace donated by the people at Le Gravenese. That's valued at $1,800. The opening bid is only $700. So if you bid early, you might win it at $700. Not likely, because it's really quite a remarkable piece, but you know, you never know. So go in there early. And there's a chance for you and your family to be photographed at the Bradford Renaissance Portrait Studio by world-recognized photographer, and receive two a $5,000 gift certificate for a 20-inch museum-quality photo. And that also, it has a very low opening bid, so get in there early. Those are some of the items. There are other fun, exciting items too, and once-in-a-lifetime experiences in the auction, and they're on the website. So take a look, make a bid.
Tonight you have the opportunity to buy art in the art auction. This goes directly to support our programs, our vision for the future. You could be a part of it right now. So please go bid, buy some art, live with art. Live with art in your home. It becomes a part of your life. Directions how to bid, that's on the screen below. Every donation, every membership, and every piece of art you buy goes directly to support our programs, support our staff. We can't thank you enough. Here's to an amazing future. Thank you so much for believing in our vision that art enriches lives.
Hi, my name is Sonia Davidian. On behalf of McClelland Sotheby's International Realty, we would like to congratulate the Pelham Art Center on their golden anniversary and thank them for enriching the lives of countless children and adults in and around our very special community. We would also like to thank Charlotte and her staff, the administration, and the board for the extraordinary job they have done, especially during these very stressful and unusual times. Our very best wishes for many, many more years of growth, development, and success in our town. Thank you so much.
The arts matter because they are food for the soul and reflection of the soul. And that makes them both inspirational and life-affirming.
Why should you support the arts in your community? The arts give us a voice when we feel we've lost our words. Not everyone can express themselves in the same way. Sometimes we need dance, sometimes we need paint, sometimes we need poetry. The arts are our voices.
I'm Janet Langsam, CEO of Arts Westchester, and I am so pleased to be here with the Pelham Arts Center celebrating 50 years. My goodness, what an occasion. So congratulations to all those wonderful people who started the Pelham Arts Center, those many years ago, and have a wonderful, wonderful celebration. And congratulations on supporting the arts in your community.
Good evening.
Thank you for joining us for the 50th anniversary virtual gala. Congratulate the Pelham Arts Center on their 50th anniversary virtual gala. It has been a great year of celebration. We have continued to celebrate even during these challenging times. Congratulations to the Pelham Arts Center for receiving the Arts Westchester Challenge Grant. Please support with your donations the Pelham Arts Center. Thank you so much. Have a great evening. Enjoy this gala.
Hi, I'm Assemblywoman Amy Paul, and good evening. Tonight we're here to celebrate the Pelham Arts Center and our heroes. From its first inception as a two-day art and music festival in 1970 until now, the Pelham Arts Center has been fostering our artistic and cultural awareness, expanding our minds, and bringing much-needed joy to our lives. Tonight, we celebrate some of today's heroes who have done so much to ensure that this educational institution continues to thrive and inspire. The honorees are an awesome group of people. Congratulations to each of them, and thank you so much. And a special congratulations to the Pelham Arts Center. 50 years is quite an accomplishment. We are forever grateful to you all for enriching our lives. Have a wonderful evening.
Hey friends, remember to support the Arts Center. There are so many ways to do it. Hit the donate button, make a recurring donation on the website, and make sure your membership is up to date.
Years ago in 1970, there are two extraordinary women, Clu Noble and Peggy Nicholson. They co-chaired the original Art Happening, which brought people together, artists together, to celebrate. We are so grateful, Clu and Peggy. Thank you so much for starting an Art Happening that turned into the thriving art center we are today.
Thank you to the board of the Pelham Art Center. Never would I have imagined this honor 50 years ago, nor would I have imagined that the exhilarating, completely community-involved art happenings would give birth to a wonderful art center that is thriving today in spite of a most difficult year and is still managing to provide the beauty, the creativity, and the joy of art to the community. Hillary Clinton recently said, "Art is not a luxury. It is a necessity to feed the spirit and the mind." Long may the Pelham Arts Center continue to do just that. And thank you once again for this award.
I think Clu said it beautifully, but I just want to say that I'm thrilled to receive the recognition for lasting the 50 years after we started this art center. Clu and I started the Art Happening in the high school gym to show that art and music are for everyone's appreciation and education. And all my life I've been involved in education, whether it was teaching or on the Board of Ed. And I hope that the Art Center would encourage this kind of service to the community. And what is art if it's not a basic form of education or a branch of learning? And I am really happy to have been a part of the foundation of PAC because it's been a major contribution to Pelham's cultural and educational ambiance. And thank you again for recognizing us.
There is a woman who had a group of people over to her house for lunch and said, "Why can't we have art year round? Let's have an art center." Turning a bicycle shop into a year-round art facility, gallery, and a places for classes. Thank you, Barbara Bertone. We are here today because of your vision to create art and community year-round in Pelham. Thank you.
Thank you, Pelham Art Center. Looking back on those early years when we started the Art Center,
I was compelled to make the art happening into a year-round art space. It was a lot of work, and it's wonderful to see it thrive today. I really believed and still believe that art is something we all need and something worth fighting for. The Art Center today is everything I envisioned and more, and I wish you all many more years of enchanting lives with art. It's great to see the exhibitions, public art programs, and educational classes continue. Thank you again.
There is a woman who has been curating at the Pelham Art Center for over 30 years. Her first exhibition, The Young Professional Show of 1989, truly visionary, way to support emerging artists, bring people together, and to further create opportunity in the arts. Thank you, Alexi Rutsch Brock, for your curatorial vision.
I just want to thank everybody. The Art Center obviously is really special to me. I grew up coming here, my parents, my mom, my father were really integral in getting this place built with the Nancy Warner and the Candidos and the Ramitas and the Reishis and the Teresianos and the Nobles and just all the Pelham people in the 70s, you know, when I was growing up and all their kids. I mean, I was started coming here and being in Susan Nathanson's clay class, I think, when I was 5. You know, so I love that whole idea of the full circle moment of my parents bringing us here, my sisters and I, and then as an adult bringing my students here, and they're continuing it. So Victoria, you'll be standing here in 40 years, and hopefully I'm here, and you know, you'll be. So it's just, I just want to, you know, it's just so great. I'm looking forward to the next 50. I hope it's as exciting as the first. It's going to just grow and be that much more, and it's all been really wonderful. So thank you so much for this.
Our next award is a Lifetime of Service Award. This woman took the original docent training from the Pelham Junior League. She was involved and in exhibiting artists in the very first Pelham Art Happening. She has consistently, for the past 50 years, been involved with the Pelham Art Center. We cannot thank you enough, Nancy Warner. I only strive and hope that more people will show the kind of dedication you have to enriching lives with art. Thank you.
It's been so great working at the Pelham Art Center all of these years. It's been like an evolution. It's changed from a bicycle shop to a wonderful gallery and lab, and it's and part of the community and the larger community than Pelham. And people like Charlotte, who have had so much outreach. It's just been great. And great fun for all of us that have worked there. And I hope we can continue to work there for a little while.
This award is for a lifetime of service. This woman has been a board member, an executive board member, a gallery advisory board member, and helped establish the Alexander Rutsch Award Biennial for Painting. Thank you, Kathy Rutsch, for what you have done for the Pelham Art Center. Inspiring artists, being a student at the Art Center, being a board member at the Art Center, a co-chair of many, many events. We are incredibly grateful for what you have done to inspire artists in the community, including having an own artist studios on your property now and establishing the Alexander Rutsch Award Biennial for Painting. Thank you, Kathy.
Thank you so much for honoring me the last 50 years. Hard to believe it's been 50 years. Making a lot of friends, bringing art to the community, and having a wonderful experience. Congratulations, and wishing the Art Center another 50 years.
Lifetime Service Award, Candace Taubner. Originally seen at the Pelham Art Center in the early 70s as an exhibiting artist, a teacher inspiring young minds, currently a gallery advisory board member. Thank you, Candy, for everything you have done for the Pelham Art Center.
When I joined the Art Center, I didn't think I'd become a lifer.
but if you're going to serve out a sentence, this is the best organization I can think of. Through the years, I've had various positions. I've been on the board. I've chaired the fundraising boutique. And my favorite thing has been curating some art shows. And the reward for this whole thing is seeing the Art Center become an integral part of the community, offering life-enhancing experiences in the arts for every age through their classes and programs and art shows. And I have to say that during this pandemic time, I feel that this is more important than ever. A big shout out to our executive director for navigating us through this difficult time with her creative solutions, the Zoom programs and outdoor art shows. And also, we have to praise the staff, past and present, who have given so much volunteering their time, making this the family that it is. I'm very proud to be part of this family, and thank you from the bottom of my heart for this honor tonight. Thank you.
Our three awardees for the lifetime of service are all current members of our Gallery Advisory Council. These women have been truly spectacular in their dedication to the Art Center for decades. Thank you, Nancy, Kathy, and Candy. You're an inspiration. A Lifetime of Service Award for an employee who is truly outstanding. Bridget Becky, the current finance manager who has been with the Art Center for over 20 years. We can't thank her enough. Her morale, upbeat, how we smile, we laugh, and our numbers are in order. We can't thank her enough. Thank you, Bridget Becky.
Thank you so much for this wonderful honor. It's been a pleasure working at the Art Center for over 20 years, and I hope for many more years to come.
Lifetime of Service for Education. This woman exhibited at the original 1970 art happening. She has taught hundreds and hundreds of students how to enjoy clay. She has been involved for the past 50 years consistently. She is the reason we have a current ceramics program. Thank you, Susan Nathanson, for everything you've done for the Pelham Arts Center.
I love teaching at Pelham Arts Center in that wonderful institute and turning people onto clay, which is my lifelong passion. And I've been able to, under the wings of Pelham Arts Center, continue this for 45, 50 years. Thank you.
There are three people receiving an award this evening for visionary leadership. All three of these extraordinary women have shown true dedication and leadership. Each one of them has been an executive board member for over 5 years. Combined, we're speaking about over 22 years of executive leadership from these three spectacular women. This award is to a woman who was president of the board for over 7 years, during two different terms over a 12-year period. Her generosity to the arts, what people have told me about Camille Romita, is truly heartwarming. When I met her, I knew that I had met a legend. Camille Romita, thank you to everything you have done to support the Pelham Arts Center, from building our building and organizing. You literally built where I'm standing right now. Thank you. She was first president of the board in 1976. She was also president of the board in the late 80s. She was chair of the building campaign, went door to door, and held endless cocktail parties to support and get the donations to build where I'm standing right now. I can't thank you enough, Diana Reichy. She founded the Art Reach Program, which is currently our outreach program. Thank you for everything you have done, a true inspiration.
It's an enormous honor to be considered a visionary. And I suppose we were all visionaries when a little band of volunteers, all volunteers, no staff, took on two little storefronts and had a dream of making it an art center. Well, that dream has come true, and it's because of so many people. I had the great pleasure of being part of a team that led the building of a new center where the gas station had been after City Service gave it to us. And it is such a thrill to see what the staff under Charlotte and her wonderful team have done to grow the Art Center. Thank you all for being involved.
It's my pleasure to award Annette Candido for her years of service on our executive board, currently on our emeritus board. When I do a 9-year comparison of fundraising, there is a woman who went above and beyond year after year to continue to get us more funding and more support for the arts. Thank you, Annette Candido, for everything you've done.
Good evening and welcome to the virtual gala. My name is Annette Candido, and I am so thrilled to be honored for my work at the Pelham Arts Center. It has been my pleasure to serve on the board for 6 years and as chair for 5 of those 6 years. For the past 28 years, I've volunteered for the Art Center in various capacities, but my proudest moments were co-chairing fundraising committees with then-president and my dear friend, Jill Orlando. We planned fabulous events with the goal of topping ourselves each time, and we did. It was hard work, but also extremely gratifying. This Legacy Award for Visionary Leadership means more to me than you can imagine. Thank you, Pelham Arts Center. Congratulations on your 50th anniversary, and congratulations to my fellow honorees. Have fun.
Congratulations. Half a century. It's difficult for me to wrap my mind around all of the history that's been created over the last 50 years by the Arts Center. In the last 1 year, they've held 117 on-site classes, 10 free public programs, 9 exhibitions featuring work from 179 artists. They've done 69 virtual programs just during the pandemic alone, and they've had an audience of over 15,000 people. That's 1 year. To me, the Arts Center is more than a nonprofit. It's an institution. It's an anchor for our downtown, and it's an anchor for us as a community, for our culture. As a former artist myself, I know, like all of you do, that art is not a luxury. It's not just pretty pictures. It's not just for kids. It's serious and fundamental. It's beautiful and inspiring. It's dangerous sometimes. It doesn't pull its punches. The Art Center has curated exhibits for us and will continue to curate exhibits for us that show us who we are, both the good and sometimes the bad. They show us who we've been, both the good and the bad. But most importantly, they show us who we need to be. And they inspire us to help us get there. Believe it or not, there will come a time when this pandemic is actually behind us. And when that time comes, we'll be building a beautiful new property right next door to the Arts Center, a beautiful new municipal center right across the street. We have investment coming into our downtown, unlike anything we've seen in decades. I personally think that Pelham's next 50 years will be Pelham's best 50 years. And the Arts Center is going to be right at the heart of it all. Thank you to everyone who has made this possible. Congratulations.
50 years of the Pelham Arts Center, and I can't wait to take you into the next 50 years. Tonight we celebrate Visions 2020, but we're also considering the future. COVID-19, we took a big hit financially with canceling our programs and not being able to run classes. We also were unable to have our in-person gala, where we wanted to have over 200 people together in a room to celebrate 50 years of the Pelham Arts Center. We did a fast transition into going virtual. We have brought over 94 art experiences to Pelham and the arts community. Of this, we've had 44 virtual studio visits, intimate conversations, getting to know an artist and their message and why they create. 9 hours of Create and Connect open studios virtually, where we can get together and communicate. We've also had 3 free art history lectures where you could learn about Asian landscape painting. We have had 3 virtual art openings. The virtual art openings are actually more intimate, where you can really talk to the artists, talk to the curators. We have had 6 days of community art engagement with free art activities in our courtyard.
We have exciting exhibitions and programs.
Our new program, Professional Development with Artists, with Stacy Miller. We've had 2 sessions so far, and we will continue them through January 2021. Free for everyone. This past summer, we had the USPS Art Project. This collaborative project, started by Christina Massey of Brooklyn, New York, supports the postal system, where we had an artist create a piece, mail it to another artist, and then mail it to the Pelham Art Center. We had 400 collaborations on view in August. We were the first place to have a physical exhibition of the USPS Art Project, which has gone on to be at the Eli Center for Contemporary Art, Sunset Studios in Dallas, Texas, and the Art Gym in Denver, Colorado. New locations are being added in Philadelphia. So what started at the Pelham Art Center is now being shown nationally.
We did a lot of renovations in the studio while we were closed down due to COVID. We repainted furniture, we replaced our sink,
and we have brand new HEPA filters in both studios. The good news?
In-person classes are back.
We are here back in person.
We've got fall classes. We're planning for winter classes and spring classes, so stay tuned.
We're following all social distancing protocols.
Temperature stations, COVID log, hand sanitizer everywhere.
Masks are required at all times.
Our priority is safety.
But the classes are back in person, so yes, we can be back. We can make art together.
So great to be back and to see you all in person.
I'm just so happy to be back here with you guys.
We have an exciting lineup of exhibitions coming up.
Right now we have Domestic Brutes, celebrating the centennial of suffrage. We're exhibiting the works of 15 different artists. This is on view until tomorrow is the last day, November 7th. So please do come by and check us out. Our exhibition programs continue. Our public art projects continue. We're here to inspire creativity. Coming back has been a little weird, but we're so happy to be here. We're so happy to engage with our audience. Art continues, and we all continue on creatively. I am so grateful for everyone who is a member of the Pelham Art Center. If you're not a member, go get a membership online right now. We have incredible auctions happening. You can bid right now.
Pelham Art Center is back. We've been here for 50 years. Here's to 50 more.
Pelham Art Center, serving the community since 1970.
Hi, it's Barry again. As important as it is to bid on the items, there's another way you can contribute. We're offering the opportunity to simply donate to the Pelham Art Center to help support the remarkable things that we've been doing for the past 50 years and help us expand into the future. A pledge of $250 could cover a student to attend an art class, one that would otherwise just be unable to do so. $500 could cover an instructor and supply costs for one of the public programs that we sponsor. $1,000 could cover a semester of outreach programs for underserved groups in the community. We need a new kiln, desperately. One $5,000 pledge can make that happen. Or that same pledge could pay for a much needed IT upgrade. We have other needs too, new lights in the courtyard. I mentioned the kiln, the entire kiln rooms needs to be renovated. Your pledge could support the ceramics program. We need to repair the roof and the heating and air conditioning and ventilation systems. Whatever you give, it's going to be meaningful. And it doesn't have to be $250. I mentioned $250, but if that's too much, give less. And I also mentioned $5,000. If you want to give more, we won't say no to that either. Whatever you can do, think about it. Be here for us. The Pelham Arts Center has been here for us and our families and for the whole community for 50 years. It's part of what makes Pelham Pelham. Let's support them. And one last thing, this is pretty cool. It doesn't have to do with the items, but it does have to do with the direct appeal, the pledging part. Anyone that pledges $250 or more will receive a mystery bag with Pelham Arts Center swag and who knows what else. And I was talking to the folks here at the Arts Center to kind of find out what would be in the mystery bags. I was blown away by what will be in some of them. Memberships to the Pelham Arts Center, artworks, beautiful ceramic sculpture. The more you donate, the more your bag will have. As a for instance, a $250 bag may include a membership t-shirt and tote bag, maybe something else altogether. A pledge of $500 or more gets you what's called a diamond swag bag. And a gift of $5,000 or more will bring you what we call the 5-carat diamond swag bag. That will have everything you might find in the $2,500 bag, plus a custom reception at the Art Center or a tour of the Art Center. We'll work with you. You'll get all those items and the reception. We'll get $5,000. That is the quintessential win-win. We've also set aside one diamond bag to be awarded to anyone who donates any amount, no matter what your pledge, $150, $100, $50 even. If you look at your computer screen right now, it gives a better breakdown of what you might find. You're donating and we're giving you these bags as a way of saying thank you, but in actuality, some of these bags are going to be worth like as much as you donate, I think. We set a goal of raising $40,000 at this event. But I'm hoping, being that this is such an incredibly significant year, our 50th anniversary, and that our needs with all that's been going on this year are as great as they've ever been, I'm hoping that we can raise $50,000. And if everybody watching at home right now can stretch just a little bit, we can do it. I know we can do it. And $50,000 would mean we can do more of what we do, stretch further, and it would allow us to do things that we've really dreamed about in the past but haven't had the finances to do. It's up to us tonight and up until the end of the auction. And that's it. So please enjoy the rest of the evening and please don't forget about us in the coming days. And I'll see ya. Bye.
Who dares disturb me when I am drafting wills and trusts? Oh, it's the Pelham Arts Center. Welcome. Thanks for stopping by. I'm a big fan of the Pelham Arts Center, and I understand you're having your gala now. That's exciting. Congratulations to 50 great years in our community. I'm excited to be on the team for the Pelham Arts Center. I'm a big fan of the work you do. I enjoyed being on the board a few years ago and staying connected to the important work you do in our community. I'm a big fan of the plastic and visual arts, and I know you do that well. And your education and outreach. So my very best wishes for 50 more years being integrated in our community in Pelham, Lower Westchester, and the region generally is a place where people can see art, make art, learn about art, and be connected to art. So everything best, George Bischoff. Enjoy the next 50 Pelham Art Center. Take care.
Art is awesome. What a cool way to enrich lives and bring people together, don't you think?
I would like to wish the Pelham Heart Center a happy and happy 50th anniversary. Thank you.
Hi again, everybody. It's Barry Cherwin again. I know you saw enough of me a few minutes ago, but I'm here one more time to remind you that you are really the most important part of this evening. And don't lose sight of that. I mentioned earlier that our goal this evening was $40,000. My hope was that we would raise $50,000. I just want to tell you that before we went virtual and this was planned as a live auction, our goal was considerably higher than that, considerably. But what we're asking, and I asked before and I'm going to ask again, is that you really stretch, really come through to it for us, and maybe some of the slack that we have as a result of having to go virtual, you can pick up. Maybe we can hit our original goal. Wouldn't that be something? Certainly a worthwhile cause, Pelham Arts Center. So don't forget, you're doing two things here now. You can be bidding on an item, and there's some great ones, ones I mentioned, ones that went unmentioned, but are on the website, and you can donate. Click now, place your bid. We need you.
Hi, I'm Allison Leia, and this is my single, We Can Still Sing. Ago, I wrote a note about my hopes and my goals and dreams, all I wanted to see and get done this year. Had my life planned day by day, sign a lease, play a show, take a trip, and find a bed to call my own. What happens now? Who knows? Find it hard to say what I want, on edge and so misunderstood. I'm selfish cause I had that to-do list. I want to disappear, feel like my whole life's sitting in here. And then you remind me, we can still sing. We have our voices, you and me. We have a home beneath our feet and a family. And we can still hope. We will joke of all that time we spent inside and how beside ourselves we were. 4 days in and I can't pick up a pen, cause when I do then I'll have to admit this is happening. But it's happening. Knowing now what I wish I knew then, would I still have planned every day like I did? Hard to not fall asleep, close my eyes and leave reality. When I say I'm scared, will you still be there to comfort me? I want to disappear, feel like my whole life's ending here. And then I remember, we can still sing. We have our voices, you and me. We have a home beneath our feet and a family. And we can still hope. One day when this is over, we will joke of all that time we spent inside and how beside ourselves we were. We can still, ooh, 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 ooh.
Ooh, 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 ooh.
that we have hand. We have right now.
Happy 50th anniversary. Thank you for having me, and stay safe, everyone.
Wow, these performances are awesome. I love art. I truly love art. I love to talk about art. Come down to the Art Center and see me. Thank you for being here tonight.
Well, I'm thrilled to be coming to you here from the Pelham Art Center. I'm sorry you all can't be here, but I hope everybody's enjoying the evening. I hope you're all contributing what you can and bidding on the artwork. When Charlotte called me and asked me to contribute, I jumped at the opportunity. I was honored. Then I started thinking which of my songs would be appropriate. All the songs I write are typically about outlaws with guns and whiskey and women. But then I did some research and I learned of an artist named Charles Marion Russell. He actually had a cowboy nickname. He was called Kid Russell. And I was hooked. And turns out he was even better than that. He helped the indigenous people of the Old West, lived with the Blackfoot for a while, and helped the Chippewa Indians regain some of their land. So in the chorus of this song, it's Api Kisinye
Kidisi Masie,
which is Blackfoot for the coyote runs west fast. This is a coyote song. Hard winter, Judith Basin in 86. Cattle gone hungry, so were the wolves. Man from Missouri started painting on postcards. People paid attention, Kid Russell was a star. Painting mountain faces, buffalo on the plains. Living with the Blackfoot, Kid Russell was his name. Kid Russell was his name.
A big Kissinye, a big Kissinye, could have seen my CA, could have seen my CA.
'60s, E.M. Russell got to work. Cowboy artist helped the landless Chippewa. Rocky Bay Preservation, it came to pass. Kid Russell was a hero for the natives we had passed.
A pink kissing, yeah. A pink kissing, yeah. Get a see my sea, yeah.
Kid Russell passed. Old by four black horses in Montana would be last. $5 million for a painting he had made. Kid Russell left the cowboys a fortune he'd forsake. Statues made and taken. Wild horses he would paint. Hated crowded places. Russell stayed the same. Kid Russell was his name. Happy 50th Art Center. Everybody contribute what you can. Thank you.
Thank you for being with us tonight at Visions 2020. Tonight was spectacular. These performers were amazing. I can't thank everyone, our teaching artists, the staff, everyone who helped produce this event, our sponsors, our members. You guys are incredible. We're re-envisioning the future, and we can't thank you enough for the support tonight. It's been an awesome party. Back to you, Stephen.
I'd like to thank everybody for their contributions, not just tonight, but over the 50 years. We couldn't have did it without you, and we cannot do it without you in the future. So please continue to donate, support the arts here in Pelham.
Happy 50 years, Pelham Arts Center.
So at this time in our program, we will be starting the DJ VJ set. So please top up your drinks, turn up your tellies, and roll back that carpet, because we're going to have a good time.
Center.